Are you wondering how to use a multimeter? It's simple. I will explain you step by step. If you're unsure which multimeter to purchase, check out the links in the description. A multimeter is a simple device that we use to measure some electrical properties to determine the correctness of devices, installations, and other things. There are two types of multimeter, analog and digital. Before you start using multimeters, I highly recommend that you use insulating gloves. Safety always comes first. In the description, you can find a link about insulating gloves. Multimeter has three parts: display, selector switch, and ports. There are different types of probes for your multimeter. Depending on what you want to measure, it's best to have all kinds of probes. They are very cheap, and they'll make your job easier. I will add links in the description for probes too. It is necessary to connect the probes correctly so that the multimeter knows what needs to be measured. Port COM is a grounding or minus mark. The black probe is no different from the red one on the inside. But preventively, so you don't short circuit, one probe is always black. Port V, you will use this port most often. Here you measure voltage, continuity, resistance. Port milliamperes, this input is used to measure the current in milliamperes. Port 10A, this port is used to measure current in amperes. The number indicates the maximum current. Here it is, 10 amps. Continuity testing gives a sound signal when two components are connected, the current passes between two points. If you can't hear the sound signal, some components are down because the power can't flow. This is the most helpful feature when you want to repair a device. This is the easiest thing. Take a resistor, adjust the resistance to the highest. Slowly lower the resistance to a smaller one until you have three digits on the screen. Don't touch both ends of the probe when measuring resistance. Because that's how you're going to count your resistance. The number you see on display is the resistance number. There are other ways to measure resistance using resistor colors. But it's far easier to use a multimeter. This is the most mysterious function for beginners. Let's solve this mystery. This is transistor test mode. It's simple: insert a transistor into this socket. The number on the screen will tell you if the transistor is correct. Compare the number to the number the company says. If they match, the transistor is right. First of all, you need to know where it is. DC voltage is in all the batteries we use, phones, car batteries. Take a battery and set the multimeter to the highest range for the DC voltage. With two probes, connect two ends of the battery, plus and dot. If you see a minus in front of a number, just replace the ends of the probes and batteries. Set to the largest range, push the two ends of the probe into the outlet. You'll see about 120 volts. Don't worry if there are minor differences. Up to 10% is expected. Be careful, 120 volts is dangerous. You should know that AC voltage has no polarity. It doesn't matter what probe you put in which way. To measure the capacitance, insert the capacitor connector into the CX socket. Before inserting the capacitors, be sure to drain them so as not to damage the multimeter. Use a screwdriver to connect the ends of the capacitor to let the electricity out. It will take the multimeter a few seconds to charge and measure the capacitance of the capacitor. Before measuring, you must disconnect the device from the voltage. It would be best to connect the probes with alligator clips to avoid the probes falling out. It is also much safer. Connect probes or alligator clips to the part where you want to measure electricity. Make sure it's set correctly for the electricity you're measuring, AC or DC. A multimeter is one of the fundamental tools that everyone needs for both beginners and professionals. It's just impossible to deal with electronics without using a multimeter. Let's face it. It's hard to find a quality multimeter when there are thousands of them. See the links to the video in the description for easier purchase of a multimeter. Today, the multimeters are more or less the same. We need to find quality, precise, and have additional functions that make it easier to work. The best option is definitely auto range. Beginners often find it difficult to adjust the measuring range. Automatic multimeters are usually more expensive, and better quality also has more accurate measurements. Auto off is one of the best additional options a multimeter can have. It happens to everyone that sometimes we leave them on after hard work. This leads to a discharged battery. We can run out of a multimeter in situations where we need them, so the auto off is a great additional feature. A good multimeter display with background lighting will work far better when we're in dark rooms than some cheap that doesn't have that option. Quality multimeters will make your job easier, and you'll enjoy using them. Common mistakes when using a multimeter: connecting a multimeter to a bigger current from which it can measure. Be careful. With that mistake, you can burn or damage your multimeter. Poor multimeter batteries will lead to false measurement results. This mistake can lead to severe injury and even death. It's crucial to replace the battery when an empty battery indicator appears. You measure a greater resistance value than the one you have set up. The multimeter will show number 1 as a not accepted result. The selector switch is in the wrong function for attempted measurement. Poorly connected probes. Additional tools with multimeter: whether you are a beginner or not, I recommend you take a look at my tool list, in which I have outlined the best tools that your electronic tools kit should have. These tools can shorten your time working and make your job easier. There's nothing better than getting off work early. If you have any questions, feel free to contact me. I would also recommend that you sign up for my email list to send you various tips for electronics, the best tools, and other useful things. Don't worry. I won't spam you. I respect your privacy.